centre of the Normandy front, with Bayeux in the background and Tilly and Otto in front, a non-stop battle has tangled up the main German forces while the great breakthrough to Cherbourg developed. Though the campaign is still in its early stages, it is clear that Montgomery has once again outgeneraled his old enemy. Bombs and artillery have brought devastation to this village from which the Hun invader has been expelled. But the life of the farm carries on as best it may. One of the many factors that helped our early successes, the flying artillery of the Royal Air Force. Air and ground units, working in closest cooperation, made use of these rockets. The ground crews, as usual, have worked like supermen to keep this flying artillery always on call. Targets are Panzer Group headquarters, radio location stations, gun positions, observation posts, and marshalling yards. Factors that prevented even greater success in Normandy, the weather. This is a sample of that windy sea that has slowed down unloading of supplies. Except at Dunkirk, Hitler has always had the best of the weather. That the Normandy campaign has gone so well is proof that our general staff did not rely on luck. Meanwhile, unloading the heavy stuff has gone on. And will go on. So much for Allied communications. Despite poor flying weather, the Allied air forces have been turning German land communications into a strong resemblance of a rough sea. A formation of Royal Air Force Mitchells attacked the marshalling yards at MEZIDON, southeast of Caen. Below these bombs were German reinforcements and French rolling stock made to work for Hitler. And now came the thrust by American troops which ultimately cut off Cherbourg. This is Saint-Sauveur. American domination of this point cut one of the two chief roads up the peninsula. Their terrific thrust took them right across in a corridor, after which they closed on Cherbourg itself. These then are the scenes through which they marched on their brilliant advance to one of the greatest ports in France. The Allied strategy is shown to have been brilliant, the choice of landing place for the invasion exceptionally well made. So great was the speed of this advance that the retreating Germans were never given the chance to get organized. Guns and bombs also pounded Quineville higher up the peninsula on the coast, and this place too was occupied shortly after. Beachhead developed into the battle for the peninsula and Cherbourg. Capture of Cherbourg may be said to be the first great prize offered to the invading Allied armies. Meanwhile, the flying bombs serve to spur us on to bring victory more swiftly and to make more sure that Germany will never do it again.